If you are in the digital marketing industry and you've been trying and you haven't sold not one digital product as of today, and you are currently on the serious verge of quitting and walking away and giving up, then you should watch this video to the end. Why? Because I'm going to tell you exactly why most, if not almost all the people who fail at digital marketing, the reason why they fail. On top of that, I'm going to give you a sales strategy that actually works right here in this video. So first off, you guys, thank you so much. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Ronnie, aka Dad Learns Money. And if you're new to this channel, thank you so much. You want to check out all of my free content on my channel. There's a lot of gems you'll find out. If you're a returning visitor, thank you guys so much for your love and support. I cannot do this YouTube thing without you guys. So if you guys have any questions about anything digital marketing, affiliate marketing, drop them down in the comments. And listen, I always reply back. But for those of you who are new to my channel, a little bit about me. I started out from the bottom. I lost everything back in 2019, 2020 during COVID. I was laid off from my job. In a matter of time, I went through my savings, my 401k. Me and my family ended up getting evicted. My car got repoed and we were thrown out on the streets. Now, mind you, it wasn't just me. It was me, my wife, and I had five kids who were living with us at that time. I literally had to beg family and friends to give me some money for a U-Haul and so that I could put me and my family's stuff in storage. Also during that time, we got blessed with a vehicle and me and my family were able to live in the vehicle. It was a five-seater car and me and my family of seven, five kids, me and my wife lived in that car. I had to figure out something very fast. At that time, not many people were hiring because of COVID. Many people were laid off and stayed at home and me and my family were suffering. So I had to figure out some type of way to generate some income to pull us out of that situation. During that process, during those hard times, I came across something called digital marketing. And after pain, frustration, and struggle, once I figured it out, digital marketing changed me and my family's life. If you want to know more about that story, you can watch the video popping up on your screen right now, where I go more in detail about that story and how I pulled me and my family from out of it to right now. We've generated over $3 million in revenue with digital marketing and affiliate marketing. That being said, let's get into the video. If you're a person, you've purchased a digital product, anything from a course, a digital product, master resale rights, PLR products, or you're just trying to sell on Etsy, I don't care what it is you're trying to do. Right now, you're struggling and you're not making any money. You haven't gotten a sale, or your sales are sporadic, a sale every now and again, or you're not getting any leads, you're not getting any views. The reason being is because you did not take the time to really create a serious sales strategy. So if you want to get out of zero sales jail, zero views jail, or zero lead sales, then you want to watch this video to the end. So right off the bat, the first thing you need to create and offer, if you don't already have one right now, is a free lead magnet, or sometimes people call them a freebie. Now, I want you to understand, you just can't create some random freebie and throw it out there and think that because you're giving away something for free, that you're going to start making a lot of money. Listen, with AI and Google and YouTube and all the ways that consumers can gather and learn information for free, your freebie needs to be a game changer. You want to think that your freebie is so good that you should be charging for it, because this is the way a customer thinks. If this person, meaning you, is giving me this freebie and all this information is in it and I didn't pay a dime, what they're thinking in their minds is, hey, if I purchase one of their products, they're going to absolutely blow my mind. So I want you to keep that in mind when you're creating a freebie or a lead magnet. And by the way, it doesn't always have to be free. You can make it a low cost price like $5, $7, or $9. But the whole point is this: whatever you create, it needs to be a game changer. It needs to really help them. It needs to help them solve a problem that they're having right now. Try and get them some type of immediate result. A second reason that you need to create a freebie or a low ticket lead magnet is because You need to be collecting emails. People are going to give you their email address if they believe that your free lead magnet or your low ticket lead magnet is going to help them. I know you've all heard it before that the money is in the email list, and this is absolutely true. I make more money on the back end through my email list than I do from just outright promoting my products up front. Your email list is going to be with you to the end of time. I've seen social media platforms come and grow. I've lost social media platforms that got banned. Sometimes they get hacked. You do not own your followers or your subscribers. The platform does. Not YouTube, not TikTok, not Facebook, not Instagram. They own your account. They own your followers. They own that traffic on that platform. Create your email list, and now you have your own traffic that you own. And worst case scenario, if anything happens, say if you did lose your social media platform, all you have to do is send an email to those people and tell them where to follow you and find you at on the social media platform when you create your new account. Also, you want to build your email list because it's easier to sell to people in your email list versus social media, because those people are meeting you for the first time. But the people who have already downloaded your product, have already consumed some of your content, they're farther down the road of the buyer's journey to make a purchase from you if they haven't already. Also, in your emails, you're able to nurture your leads and build trust within them faster than social media. Because we all know, if you're on social media and you're putting out content, that takes time. You got to come up with the ideas. You got to create the scripts. You got to create the graphics, whatever you're going to put in your videos. Then you have to actually film the videos. Then you have to edit the videos. And then there's post-editing, like adding in SEO. It can really get overwhelming and time-consuming. So if you're just starting out, that's a lot harder to do than sending out an email. Emails can be automated and pre-scheduled for you to where you're still marketing to those people through email, which is going to make up for a lot of the time to where you can't create content as often as you like. And if you did not know, email marketing is 40% more effective than social media alone. Emails are not going anywhere. When was the last time that you created an account on any platform, any software, even a bank account? You got a new phone and they didn't ask for your email. So emails, no matter what you think, no matter what you've been told, are the key to your success and long-term success. But again, I stress, you're not going to build trust with your email list or your email subscribers if your free lead magnet or your freebie is trash. That's going to set the standard to where they're not going to want anything else from you. All they're going to do is unsubscribe from your email list because what you gave them was trash. So that's what they're going to think about your entire business. So it's very important, very critical that whatever you give them for free or a low ticket that they're getting in exchange for you getting their email address has to be on point. If it is, then all your emails are going to do is just reinforce what they're already feeling and confirm that you may be the potential person who can help them on their journey and make them motivated to purchase any future products that you offer them. Through your emails, you're going to be able to build that trust factor. They're going to get to know you. After they get to know you, they're going to get to like you. After they like you, they're going to trust you. And when they trust you, they're going to buy from you. So that's number one. You want to create a freebie or a low ticket offer that you can offer them in exchange for their email address. And if you already have one, but you're not getting any downloads, then you need to rethink it. Is this product really good? Can I make it better? Is the title catchy? Do my customers understand what this digital product is for? Do they understand how it can help them? Do they see the value in it? For example, if you need some examples to see what I'm talking about, in my YouTube description, I also offer free products and free downloads and freebies. I offer a freebie that gives my customers 98 digital product ideas. So if they're just getting started, this is going to point them in the right direction. I offer them free landing pages. So if they're at the stage where they're trying to sell their digital product online, I give them a template to get started. All they have to do is just tweak and make some minor changes instead of creating it from scratch. I also, inside my Discord community, give away freebies as well. That's an incentive for people who take the time to join my private community that I give them just for doing so. And that's a free list of viral hooks. So when they're ready to go on social media, I give them some hooks that they can say in order to stop scrolls on social media. But this is what I mean. You want to give your people something of value that they see the value in that can actually help them with the problem that they're having. Now, moving on to number two. Like I said, you may already have a digital product, whether it's a Master Resell Rights course or somebody else's course, or whatever you're promoting might be high ticket. And right now, you're not getting any sales on that high ticket offer. And if you aren't getting any sales from your high ticket offer, it's because mainly the people don't trust you, they don't know you, and also it's just because you're just starting out. I want you guys to understand there's levels to this game, okay? Don't expect just because you bought something and you put it out on the internet that people are gonna buy it. Everybody who's successful earned the trust of the people who supported them and contributed to their success by becoming customers and investing in their products and their services. So you have to understand you're at ground zero. What you can do to start getting sales to your high ticket offer is first offer something that is low or mid ticket. Now I want you to understand this. There is a gap between you and your customer, and you have to meet them where they're at. So imagine if you're a new creator, a new entrepreneur, or whatever you want to call yourself. Right now, you just have a free digital product, and then you have a $500 or $1,000 high ticket product. You want to bridge the gap. I want you to think that there are steps leading up to that high ticket offer. You want to create products in between that will lead them towards the high ticket offer. And you have to be able to understand that your customers may not be ready to purchase a high ticket offer yet. For a number of reasons. They may not have the money yet, or they may not be comfortable purchasing from you yet because they just met you. Now understand, just because they don't purchase that high ticket offer, it doesn't mean it's because they're not into you. They might be feeling you, they might can resonate with you, but just right now, at this particular time in their lives, $500 just seems uncomfortable for them. So that's why it's good to have a low and mid-ticket product or products in between. Now, this is assuming that your free download, imagine they gave you their email address for that free download and they're blown away, you actually help them. Then next, your low-ticket or mid-ticket product is going to be available to them to where they said in their minds, wow, this is really good. This thing right here looks like it can help me too. And I'm trusting that since I got this free product from this person and it really helped me, if I invest in this additional product that they're selling, I'm going to get even more value. That being said, if you understand that, you can have a low or mid-ticket product that's anywhere from $17 to $49. If you've been following me on my content, I recently dropped a video where I explained to you how I turned a $29 ebook into six figures. If you want to know more about that video and how I did it, it'll be popping up on your screen and you can check it out after you finish watching this video. Now, because these products are reasonably priced, you're increasing the chances of you getting some sales versus a $500 plus high ticket offer. And just think about it. Even if you sold two of these digital products priced at $49 every single day, you're potentially making $100 per day. But it's so much easier for a person to purchase a $27 or a $37 or a $49 digital product from you first, especially if they just met you, versus a $500 digital product. And again, the same rule applies to your free product. You want to make sure that this product is really, really good. It really helps them and it blows their minds away. Again, you're earning trust from this customer. Don't make your free product a wow factor, then your paid product a flop. Make sure that you're helping them get from point A to point B, that you deliver on whatever you promise for whatever they purchase, and that it helps them fix the problem that they're having. Because if you do this, now they're going to really be open and motivated to purchase your high ticket products. Now, for the record, to make sure we're on the same page, this mid-ticket offer, you want to make sure that you don't give them all the sauce, all right? If you give them all the sauce, they're not going to see the value in your high-ticket product. But you want to give them just enough to where they feel like they got their money, if not more than their money's worth, from the product. Now, number three, I've already touched on this a little bit, but I'm going to dive deeper. I want to really make sure that you guys understand this. Whether it's your free product or your low and mid ticket offer that you're selling, you want to make sure that they both and all of your products are solving one specific problem for the customer. In order to do that, you need to know what your specific customer's pain points are, whatever they're struggling with, so that you can do this effectively. This means that you can't just randomly go out and create something for a whole bunch of people. I want you to imagine in your mind one person that represents millions of people, but think of one person who's having this one problem and create the solution to this problem in the form of a digital product. If you're unsure about how to do that, one, I recommend that you join my private community where I talk about this in more details. But a quick and easy way to help you through this, if you're just getting started, is think of yourself. Ask yourself where you were a month ago, 3 months ago, a year ago, 3 years ago, and go back to that person and imagine if you yourself now could go back and help them. What was that big problem you were facing at that time? So remember, you could be multiple steps of your potential customer. Go back to the old you, which is where they could potentially be now, and help them with that one problem. Maybe it was, I didn't know how to create my first landing page. Or maybe it could be, I didn't know what to do or say to get started on social media. But just one specific thing for one specific person. And once you have that one problem, create the solution for it in the form of a digital product. And guys, this is all a process. This is all your process and their process. And you have to trust the process. So if you're helping them with this problem and the product they purchase or downloaded for free helps them with this problem, they're going to gradually move from point A to B to C to D to wherever you're trying to get them. Now, moving on, that was our sales strategy. Now we got to talk about our content strategy. Listen, it don't matter if you got a cool download and it really will help somebody, or a low ticket offer. It doesn't matter if you know who your specific customer is and the problem they're having. None of what you have, your domain, your emails, whatever you have in place and are ready to sell, none of that matters if you don't have a content strategy. Your content strategy is going to help you market and promote and spread the word about what you have to offer. So if you don't put out content, or you're putting out content but you're doing it the wrong way, you're not going to get any emails. Nobody's going to want to download and definitely not purchase anything from you. So your content strategy is just as important as your sales strategy, if not more important, because if you're not getting eyeballs, if you're not getting human beings to your product and offers, you're not going to make any money. To make this very simple for you, I'm going to tell you some types of content you should be creating if you want to attract the right people to your products and your offers. And one of those things is it needs to be shareable content. People share what inspires them, motivates them. If they learn something, they're going to share that content to other people. Now, there's two types of way you could put out content. There's content that you could put out where you're actually in the content. That means you're showing your face and you're speaking. And then there's content where people are going faceless. That means they're not in the content, they're not speaking, or they could be using AI. Now, I'm not against anybody going faceless. You could do that too. And there are tons of people making money with faceless content. But what I'm going to talk about in this video is actually being in the content. For me, that has worked way more better than faceless marketing, and I've done both. And I just truly believe that people buy from people. So if there's a sense of urgency for you to start getting some sales and start growing your business and getting some results, then I highly recommend that despite all your fears, despite all your lack of knowledge and your lack of expertise, that you start polishing yourself with putting out content that you're actually in. Once you've decided that you're going to create content, there's two types of content you can create, and there's long form and there's short form. The short form content you can use on things like Facebook, Instagram Reels, or TikTok. I would recommend that you put out some short form content. This is going to help get you awareness, People are going to discover you and they get more views and more exposure versus long form content. And this is not to say that you shouldn't be creating long form content. I'm just saying that you should also do short form content, which is going to bring and draw people to your long form content. Now, with your short form content, you want to put out stuff that's inspirational, giving some tips, and this could all be text on screen, or you can actually be talking to it. But this is going to motivate people to share and engage with your content. And a cool thing about short form content is it doesn't take a lot of effort. You can literally just press record and film yourself working at your laptop or your desktop computer. You could be doing laundry. You could be walking down the street. None of that matters. What you just want to do is make sure that you're putting out some content that's between 15 to 30 seconds or 5 to 15 seconds, and make sure whatever text is in your content inspires, motivates, and educates. Because you're putting out this short form content that's inspiring, motivating, and educating, people are going to leave comments, people are going to like it, people are going to ask you questions, and people are going to ultimately share your content. One thing you must understand, just like we've been talking before, none of it's going to work. You're not going to get any results unless it's catering and resonating to your target audience. Remember, we're not trying to capture the entire world's attention. We're just trying to capture the attention of our specific customer. So if you have kids, you could be playing with your kids in the park or going to one of their sports events, something that they can resonate with, that they actually live in their actual life, that catches their attention. Now, alongside that, you also want to post content where you're actually talking, just like I'm doing now. And you can still do this in short form content. I would make this content anywhere from 30 seconds or 45 seconds up to a minute or longer if need be. But you want some slightly longer content to where you're just talking directly in the camera to your ideal customer. Now, when you're doing this, don't overthink it. Just talk, be personable, be authentic, be yourself. Don't worry about your environment. Don't worry about if you don't have a nice mic or a nice camera. All of that is going to work in your favor because your ideal customer is going to get it. Only thing that matters is you got to make sure that you're being yourself, because the customer or your ideal customer can smell anybody who's faking. If you're looking at me right now, I could have put on a suit and a tie. I could have all this glamour around me, but that's not me. I want people to accept me for me. I don't want to have to become something that I don't like, that makes this whole process miserable for me, just to get people to purchase my products. I'm only trying to attract the people that resonate with me, that get me, and these are going to be the people that are going to ultimately purchase my products. I'm only creating content for those people. Now, when you're talking inside these videos, share your story. Tell them how you got started. Tell them what's happening right now in your business. Tell them where you are. Tell them things you wish you knew before you got started that you know now. Tell them the stuff that you're struggling with right now and how you overcame it, or how you're working to overcome it. My point is, you have to have some type of personality in your videos. You want to make it easier for people to watch and keep watching you and your content. So, with that being said, you're going to want to make sure you have catchy hooks. When they're scrolling on social media, you want to say things right up front that catches their attention and stops them from scrolling. And even if you're not speaking in your video, say, for example, you're doing a 5-second video, your viral or your catchy hook should be above your head and in plain view that catches their attention right off the bat. After you understand that, then the second thing is, you want to start creating the content and creating content consistently. Like I said, this is all a process. None of what I'm saying isn't going to work if you don't do everything all the way to the T. So if people discover you and they go and check out the rest of your content and see that you're posting content every other week, every other month, or it's all over the place, there is somebody on social media that is doing the same thing, trying to reach the same person, but doing it way more frequent than you. Who do you think they're going to follow? Who do you think they're going to trust? To the customer, their problem is immediate. There's some urgency. They want to get to their desired outcome or their results as quickly as possible. And if you're inconsistent, they don't believe that you can help them. What you're basically saying is, I know you have a problem, but it can wait till I'm able to put out more content. So you'll be all right. Versus another person who is putting out not just one piece of content a day, but multiple. So whatever you have to do to be consistent in your content, you need to make that happen. Start with whatever is reasonable and realistic in your life and just make sure you maintain that level of consistency. And if possible, try and grow and build from that. If you really struggle with finding the time to create content, I highly suggest that you batch create your content. So that means taking a day or a weekend and just record all of your content in those days, and then you can auto-schedule those posts on different days throughout the week and or month. There are also AI tools and software that you can use to help you with this as well. I use a platform or an AI tool called Video AI, and I'll leave the link to this software down below this video in the YouTube description. But what I do, I just create the content, upload it to the software, and it posts it for me all throughout the week, every single day. It adds all of my captions, it adds all of my hashtags, everything that I need, and then it repurposes my content to YouTube, to Facebook, to Instagram, and even TikTok. And now this helps me a lot because it's just a set it and forget it, and it helps me make sure that I'm maintaining my consistency on social media and online. You can also check out this video right here, popping up on your screen to where I go more in depth and demonstrate how this software works. Another cool thing I do to make sure I put out good content and put out good content consistently is throughout the day or week, I get these ideas about content. But what I do, I just go ahead and do them. Why it's on my mind, why it's fresh. And even if I gotta just record it and save it as a draft, I just go ahead and knock it out. And I highly recommend you do that as well. What you can do now, don't wait till later to do, because we all know life is going to happen. You're going to forget, or you'll feel like you'll never have the time to do it. Another cool thing that you can do that I highly recommend, which is going to kill two birds, is creating long form content. A lot of the times what I do, I just sit down and I record long form content just like this video that you're watching. And then I use AI software like video.ai, and it chops it up into bite-sized content. Using this software, say for example, I have a 20 to 30 minute video that I posted on YouTube. When I upload that finished product or that finished video into Video AI, it's going to create me 20 to 30 and sometimes 40 pieces of bite-sized content that I can repurpose to Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok, and even YouTube Shorts. And when it does that, it saves me so much time and energy. I highly recommend that you create some long-form content for a platform like YouTube, which in my opinion is the best platform to start promoting and marketing your digital marketing business. You can also take that content and create 30 pieces of short form content that you can repurpose to all other platforms. Again, if you want to check out this software, I have a video for it, but you can also see the link in the YouTube description and learn more information. Lastly, when you do batch create it, if you can, separate the time between the entire process. So day one could be batch recording all your content, and the second day could be editing and posting your content. Or you could just have a day three and post and schedule all your content on that day for the entire week. That'd be a day aside to post your content, adding the viral hooks, adding the captions, adding the call to action, adding your hashtags. It'll all be taken care of. Now you have 30 days to batch record again. Again, I stress that you break things down like that because it's going to make you feel like you're less overwhelmed. It's going to take away that whole stress factor, and you'll be able to do a little bit at a time because you're breaking it down into chunks. And like I said, when it comes to consistency, it doesn't have to be every single day. It doesn't have to be multiple times throughout the day. Just maintain some type of level of consistency to where you're reliable and people know that you're creating content, and they know when to expect that content because you're consistently putting it out on that day and time. Moving on to the third thing that a lot of people don't pay attention to, and this is looking at your analytics, looking at the data, looking at what's happening to the content that you're posting. It's going to help you get better and improve, and you'll know what's going on. You're going to know what you need to work on and what you need to double down on because it's giving some good results. So many people just post the content and only look at the views, and they're asking themselves, why am I not getting any views? Why am I not getting any comments? That is what your analytics is for, you guys. Maybe you're posting at the wrong time. It doesn't always mean that your content is bad. It can just mean that your audience isn't online at this time. Or maybe you're not getting any views because your hook is bad or your thumbnail is bad. So nobody is clicking it or stopping their scroll because you haven't hooked them. Or maybe people are clicking it, but they're not watching it all the way to the end. Maybe in your content, you get off the subject and you start rambling and talking about irrelevant things and they swipe away. All of these things you can learn inside your analytics. You can find your analytics on all social media platforms. You can see a snapshot overview of your entire profile and even a specific video. But your content is your traffic source. If you don't fix your traffic source, there won't be any traffic to your offers, to your landing pages, and then there won't be any sales. So before we start wondering, why am I not getting sales? We have to go to the source of the problem and see what's happening there and see how we can fix it and or improve it. Another example is sometimes your content is good, but it needs to be pushed out further into the algorithm. And there's ways to do that. For example, when people like your content or leave a comment in your content, that's going to push your content out further into the social media platform because the algorithm thinks and understands that a lot of people are enjoying it and reacting to it. So if you're not getting enough likes or no likes at all, you have to figure out how to get people to do that. If you're not getting comments, you have to figure out how you can get people to comment. Sometimes this could be something simple as asking them to leave a comment. In my YouTube videos, I say, hey, if you guys have any questions, make sure you leave a comment down in my YouTube description. I always reply back. That's going to motivate people to take action and leave a comment. It could be something as simple as just asking them. But if you're not getting any engagement, your content isn't going to get pushed. Even if it's great content, people may not like or leave a comment, but you got to figure out how to get them to do that and make sure you're putting out content that motivates them to do that. Another thing about your analytics, not all videos that you put out are worth repeating. That's what analytics are for. They tell you which content was well received or which content you may have to abandon. We want to double down on the content that gets results, that gets engagement, that gets likes, that gets comments, that generates leads, that turn into sales. If you start seeing content that's doing any of those things, your audience is telling you they want more of it. So put out more content about that subject and talk about it in different ways. Content marketing is all about testing and seeing what works and what doesn't. Focus on your content that generates the biggest and most results and double down on them. Improve them, make them better. When you do these things, you're going to see the algorithm starting to learn about your channel more, and your audience is going to want to watch more of your content because you're talking about stuff they want to hear, stuff that's searchable, stuff that people are asking for, that you explain in a unique way that they like. If you put out a video or some videos that only get 40 to 50 or 100 views, and then you drop another video that gives you 800 or over 1,000 views, that's a hint right there to where you should be creating more content like that. So guys, in a nutshell, the two most important things you need to know to turn things around in your digital marketing business is a strong sales strategy and a strong content marketing strategy. These are the two biggest keys to digital marketing success. One last thing that I would like to add that's also important is don't give up. You got to keep going. If you're not seeing the results, keep going. If you're not making any sales, keep going. If you're feeling discouraged, keep going. because ultimately this is a marathon and it's not going to be glam and bright lights and happy days and sunshines and rainbows. You got to tough it out through the entire process. And the only people who win are the people that overcame all of their challenges and never gave up and quit. If you're stuck, if you don't know what to do, if you're confused, there's plenty of people who are already online and on social media that are already getting the results that you desire. Go follow those people. Get inspired by their people. I'm not saying steal their content, but find out what's working for them and tweak it and make it your own and use that same strategy or technique in your own content. I see so many people online who are actually doing pretty good, but they feel like they're not because they're not getting the results in their own desired time. So they feel like they're a failure or they're doing it wrong and they give up and quit. There's always a reason why stuff is happening, but sometimes all you need to do is just keep going and be patient. There's so many answers out there. Even if you don't have the money to invest in a coach or a mentor or another course, there are people out there that you can get inspiration from that'll help you and mentor you, whether or not they know that they're mentoring you or not, that you can get inspired from. Success leaves clues. Find out the clues and use it to your advantage and grow your digital marketing empire. I want you guys to understand that I've been on social media for some years now, and I feel like I'm doing exceptionally well, but there are still days where even I get discouraged. I feel like I should quit too, so it doesn't go away. The thing that keeps me motivated is I see the results of what's happening now, and I'm patient with myself, and I find ways to keep myself motivated and inspired. You're gonna have to figure out how to do that for you as well. Not everything on the internet is going to be able to help you. Sometimes the help only comes from within, and also in my case, from above. That being said, if you like to work with me, you can join in my community, which is going to be down below this video in the YouTube description. It's a private Discord. Or if you like me to coach and mentor you to help you with everything we just talked about in this video, I can also do that for you as well. You'll see the link to book a call with me where we can talk about how we can make that happen. Till then, you guys, make sure that you watch the next video popping up on your screen, because when you pair everything that you learned in this video with what you're going to learn in the next, it's going to make you way more powerful. Till then, stay blessed, and I'll see you on the other side of success or the next video, whichever comes first. I'm out.